This video will cover using Mimecast in Outlook. To start, go to the top of your screen and click on Mimecast. Now, you're not going to see what I see because I've already authenticated myself, and you have to authenticate yourself first. So if you see when this new window pops up, there's authentication settings, I'm already authenticated, you will have to click authenticate, maybe it's going to prompt you to type in your password, maybe one or two more steps, and you'll be good to go. Now that you've been authenticated, you can start using all of its functions. In this video, we're going to cover three functions. The first one is accessing messages that have been put on hold. Now, Mimecast sends you an email every morning at 9 a.m. and every afternoon at 4 p.m. with all the messages that have been put on hold. But you're actually able to access those messages whenever you want throughout the day. Simply click on hold messages and you will be brought to this new screen, where you get to see all the different messages that have been put on hold for various reasons. When you click on a message, you can either release it and send it to your inbox or reject it, just like you can do to messages that Mimecast emails to you at the beginning and the end of the day. Next, I'm going to show you how to access your online inbox. In your online inbox, every single message that you have ever sent or received is stored. Even if you've deleted it, even if you sent it 3 years ago, everything is there. So this is really useful if you're looking for something from, say, a long time ago, something that you deleted. It's all going to be there. The final thing we're going to cover is how to report spam. If you get a message that is either spam or phishing, click on the message and then click on Report Spam in the Mimecast tab. And those are three useful functions of Mimecast in Outlook.